my perspective, it seems like the end of the road that they will probably have to file for winding up at some stage, says Sandeep Parekh, managing partner, FinSec Law Advisor. These are some of the questions answered by him. Kumar Mangalam Birla is stepping down from the Vodafone Idea board. Is it a sign of what is to come for Vodafone Idea, and how tough is it for telecom players to operate in such an environment? The answer was, they are facing challenges with respect to payments for spectrum and there is increased competition because of Jio. I do not think the future is uncertain, it is looking pretty certain in terms of the large payments which have to be made for spectrum, use of past years, unless they can hugely capitalize and then compete, which looks quite difficult given the kind of numbers involved and the fact that they are not able to get the right kind of equity investment to scale up that size. What can Kumar Mangalam Birla stepping down mean approaching NCLT and winding up, selling out to another investor, Vodafone PLC taking a bigger stake? He said neither of the two current promoters appear interested in capitalizing the entity, but nobody would want to invest such an overwhelming amount of money. I really do not see a choice. Even if a white knight comes, he will want return on capital, and unless they get such an overwhelming dose of not just capital but of optimism, I do not think they are going to. With the existing shareholders or writing down the investments, I really do not see that happening. Given the fact that it could be the end of the road for Vodafone Idea, let us take a look at some of the banks that have big exposure to Vodafone. For example, IndusLand Bank, PNB, SBI and Yes Bank. Do you think it's going to be tough for the Indian banking system as well? For this, he answered, I really do not want to comment on banks' exposure, but there could be substantial write-downs for all the lenders to this entity. It seems to be a natural corollary. If that were to take place, would not competition now be a big challenge? The answer was, I'm not even getting into that question. My point is, telecom and airlines are very different industries. You cannot have a shrunk Vodafone which will continue to exist. So I do not see that why either of the competitors would buy a company with such massive debts. I really do not see much scope for white knight.